Welcome back to the Corner Faster, Get Fast series. Brett Meinhardt Park, Porsche Cayman GT4. We're most of the way through 50 laps to get up to speed using the iRacing simulator. This video, laps 37, 38, and 39, we essentially send it in each corner, basically trying to rip it as hard as possible. Previously, we spent a lot of time analyzing and perhaps overanalyzing the track in terms of learning the layout, looking ahead with purpose, using the whole track, driving to limit of grip, working out gear selection, shaping each corner to prioritize exits, getting on and off the brakes, getting back on the throttle, turning the wheel into each corner, unwinding, and most recently, black car. Now it's time to stop breaking down our driving and try to pull it all together and carry as much momentum as we think we can make it into each corner. Maybe one tip per corner. So in Big Bend, just carrying as much momentum into this spot, mid-corner, the longest trail break possible. Thinking about that transition from left to right and carrying as much momentum through that transition right here into the right-hander. For the uphill, just trying to carry momentum into the second portion of the corner, up the hill, into the pitch of the hill. Really trying to think about making the apex at West Bend here, and then thinking about that period just after turn-in where the track flattens out and getting a good launch into the downhill. But that's pretty much it. I'm not trying to break down technique or portion of the corner, essentially just maybe one idea about each corner and then head out on track and send it. Whereas some of the previous steps definitely helps to look at what we're doing with each input to avoid developing bad habits and also just as a way to analyze and really learn the track inside and out. At this stage, there's a lot to learn about just pulling it all together and sending it around the track, noticing just exactly how much the car can take and making adjustments in sort of a more holistic way. But that wraps up all but the last 10 laps of our up to speed in 50 laps, and despite the little bit of an off there in the downhill, that was a decent lap at 52.1. So we'll head back out in the last 10 laps for a 10 lap run. Try to stay as consistent as we can.